The place to introduce today is Gwangjang Market. Gwangjang Market is famous for its food alley for young people. There are many restaurants that sell various food at low prices, led by Mung bean pancakes or Bindaetteok in Korean. However, it is relatively unknown that Gwangjang Market is the first permanent market in Korea and the largest traditional market in Seoul, established in 1904. Unlike other markets where the Japanese exercised management rights at the end of the Joseon Dynasty due to the expansion of Japanese influence, Gwangjang Market is said to have firmly maintained the reputation of the Korean market based on pure homeland capital. Perhaps that's why the old stores that sell traditional Korean clothes, shroud, and wedding items necessary for ceremonial occasions still maintain their reputation. These traditional stores are located in the area just outside the food alley and are open until 6 p.m. After the evening, when the food alley starts to be crowded, the traditional shopping area becomes quiet. That's why people usually think of the food alley when they think of Gwangjang Market. Today I will show the traditional market and the food alley together. I visited the traditional market during the day and the food alley in the evening. Let me introduce the traditional market first. The sign on the upper left says Gwangjang Market Clothing Wholesale. It is the entrance of Gwangjang Market. It is located on the right side after exiting exit 4 of Ujiro Saga Station on Subway Line 5 and passing Cheonggyecheon Stream. I don't know why, but stores on the way to entering the market are closed. Is it the aftermath of COVID-19? After passing the place where clothing stores and food stalls are mixed, you can see the draper stores. When the market was established in 1904, it is said the drapers were the main players. They operated the market based on the capital accumulated from the textile industry. In other words, the draper stores here are a living history from the beginning of Gwangjang Market to the present. There are hanbok stores. Hanbok is a traditional Korean costume with a very long history. It is said that there is a record of hanbok for the first time in the mural paintings of ancient tombs of Goguryeo, an early country of the Korean peninsula. They were painted between the 4th and the 7th centuries. Hanbok's design has changed little by little with the times. However, the basic form has been maintained. Despite such a long history, hanbok is not worn by ordinary people unless it is a special event such as a wedding or a birthday party for the elderly. The method of making hanbok is difficult, and mass production is not easy, and therefore the price is high. There is also a perception that hanbok is outdated. Hanbok is such a beautiful clothes for anyone to see. However, with those shortcomings, people are getting farther and farther away from hanbok. These days, there are many cases where people who go out to the old palaces borrow and wear hanbok. This is one of the cases the value of hanbok is reconsidered. Food alley is closed when you get up at Jongno-oga Station on Subway Line 1. There is a long line before entering the food alley. They sell twisted breadsticks or gwabaegi in Korean here. It is so famous that there is always a long line every time I come here. A large sticky rice twisted breadstick costs 1,000 won or about 70 cents. I don't know the taste because I haven't tried it, but it's cheap enough for people to wait and eat. I'm impatient and give up eating today. Restaurants selling bindaetteok are the most popular here. There are dozens of bindaetteok restaurants and stalls on both sides of the alley and the passage in the middle. These bindaetteok restaurants have a variety of menus in addition to bindaetteok, but bindaetteok and meatballs are the most popular. This is the birthplace of the little gimbap or rice rolled in lava, nicknamed drug gimbap. Unlike ordinary gimbap, there are few ingredients in this gimbap. Uniquely, however, there is a separate sauce for dipping gimbap. The combination of this sauce and gimbap gives an addictive taste. These days, other restaurants in the market also sell drug gimbap. So the taste is similar, but if you want to experience the original, try the gimbap here. Korea had a strong image of a drug-free country, but these days, news about drug crimes is often heard. Therefore, a bill that prohibits the use of drug as trademark names is being promoted. It's hard to tell if this is necessary. Now I am at my favorite bindaetteok restaurant. You can get a glimpse of the process of making bindaetteok while waiting in line. You can see mung beans being soaked in water. In the back, there is a millstone that grinds mung beans. On the left, you can see the dough made with ground mung beans, vegetables, and meat. The restaurant's employee is frying the dough on a large greased iron plate. There's a finally table after waiting a few minutes. As usual, I'm ordering vegetable bindaetteok and meatball as a combo. We also order noodles under the pretext of needing carbohydrates. You can go without makgeolli. Even after ordering like this, the price is about $10. The two of us can eat our fill. The reason why so many people flock to the food alley in Gwangjang Market is probably because of the huge cost effectiveness. Gwangjang Market is a typical Korean traditional market where you can buy traditional Korean items and taste cheap foods. Both young and old people love this market. It also contains the historical meaning as the first permanent market in Korea. People who come here are willing to accept inconveniences such as complexity and waiting. I hope that it will remain as a market for the common people forever.
Gwabaegi 4개 주세요.